This is like a giant vacuum cleaner for the atmosphere, and it could be one answer to slashing Earth's carbon emissions.
We take it out of the air, so we reverse climate change.
This system is cleaning up some of the 33 billion tons of carbon dioxide that humans will release into the atmosphere by the end of the year. And the International Energy Agency says it's the highest concentration ever. Companies are increasingly facing pressure from consumers and investors to reduce their carbon footprints. So some are turning to the carbon capture industry that's forecasted to be worth approximately $15 billion by 2027. Microsoft and Audi are investing in this technology, while Coca-Cola is purchasing the carbon that's caught.
We believe it's one of the solutions to fight climate change.
But some climate experts doubt the technology can have a meaningful impact on the environment.
Probably one of the biggest challenges here is having captured it, what can you do with it?
We visit one of the largest open-air carbon capture facilities on the planet to see how it absorbs, then sells its CO2, and how that could help companies become cleaner. A lot of companies are trying to remove carbon dioxide from the air. Some want to capture it directly by attaching filters on trucks and factories, or by installing ventilation systems in meeting rooms.
Here we basically have air being pumped inside this chamber.
But Climeworks takes carbon dioxide directly out of the atmosphere.
We blow air through this collector using a ventilator. The CO2 sticks inside this box and stays there.
Natalie Casas leads Climeworks' research program. She says this facility is made up of 30 ventilators that can pull in about 1,500 tons of carbon dioxide out of the atmosphere every year.
Inside the collector, we have a filter material. This filter material is able to catch CO2.
Casas says the biggest challenge is making it affordable to set up and use. Building and installing just one of these ventilators here at this facility costs as much as $220,000. And it also needs a lot of electricity. So to clean up the amount of CO2 someone in the US would typically produce in about a month, that's everything from commuting to work to consuming food and watching TV, the company says it would cost around anywhere from $600 to nearly $900.
The target, of course, is to bring costs down, to bring the energy requirements down, and to make it easily scalable.
So Casas has been working on designing larger plants that would use renewable energy sources and require less steel. But one of the most promising ways to offset the cost has been tapping directly into the captured CO2. Climeworks stores the carbon dioxide it collects into these tanks. Then it sells it to this Coca-Cola factory that produces bottled water. Here, recycled carbon dioxide is injected in the water to make it fizzy.
30% of our production is done with the recycled CO2 from Climeworks.
Patrick Whitweiler oversees the carbon dioxide project at Coca-Cola. He says early on, there were challenges, like turning the carbon dioxide into the right kind of liquefied form.
We run a lot of tests and validations just to be sure that the quality remains on the highest level.
Whitweiler says using recycled CO2 is significantly more expensive than the commercial kind, but Coca-Cola is committed to lowering its environmental footprint. Over time, he expects the cost to diminish, and that would allow the company to expand the use of recycled CO2 from bottled water to other drinks like Coke.
We're testing it, and we look into further expansions.
Making drinks fizzy is just one way to use recycled CO2. Carbon capture startups have also been experimenting with creating fuel, toothpaste, and plastic. Climeworks also has another way to profit from the carbon it captures. The startup sells what it calls a carbon removal service, so that individuals or companies like Shopify and Audi can offset their own emissions.
You are flying to Mallorca, but I know it's not so good for the environment. I really want to compensate. You can buy carbon dioxide.
This part of the industry is booming and fast evolving as regulators and climate analysts debate how to best price this type of service.
There are better ways of capturing the carbon dioxide than they're using.
Sandra Kentish is a professor at the University of Melbourne who tracks and compares carbon capture systems around the world. She says it's harder to absorb CO2 from the atmosphere rather than a direct source of pollution.
The CO2 concentration in the atmosphere is only about 0.04%. Cement production, as an example, CO2 concentrations around 30%. So it's hundreds of times easier to capture from something like a cement flue gas than it will be for directly from the atmosphere.
This inefficiency means that to capture 1% of the world's emissions in a year, Climeworks would have to build around 800,000 ventilators. But CASA says the company's technology can still make a difference.
Unfortunately, the mess is already here, so we need to take out CO2.
And Climeworks plans to take out more CO2 with a new facility in Iceland that was built with some funding from Microsoft. When it opens in September, the company says the plant will be able to absorb about 4 times more than its Swiss facility. But this time, the carbon dioxide won't be recycled. It'll be injected in the ground and turned into a rock.
These are these white crystals. So this CO2 is actual CO2 which was in the air.
And this kind of evolution is how Climeworks hopes its technology will become cheaper so that it can clean the air for companies searching for new ways to reduce their own emissions.